поцелую тебя на губоньке.
Давайте, да.
I could never live on an island. We understand you have a government account.
Yes, indeed.
Hello?
I have to share this with you. Since I've been on this island, and it's been what, Noel, maybe 7 or 8 hours? And I just... What a beautiful island. It's very hard to describe, but it's really something quite special. But you're not here to listen to me. We're all here to listen to the Minister of Fisheries, who will begin speaking very shortly. Are we ready?
Ready.
Good evening, residents of the island of Solomon Gundy. I'm Nelson Stidwell, Minister of Fisheries and Atmosphere for Canada, and I am very pleased to be able to speak with you via satellite this evening. As I'm sure you are all very well aware, these have been difficult times for the Atlantic fishery. Stocks have become depleted, and the return from our fish on international markets has been falling steadily.
And we've seen a lot of foreign vessels fishing off our coast, too, yo.
In a highly competitive future, we must manage our resource properly now. That is why I'm speaking with you tonight. Taking into account the latest scientific data pertaining to the management of Atlantic fish stocks, I have made the following decision. For the next 3 years, Canada will reduce its annual catch of all ground fish species by 4%. After intense consultation with your provincial government, I have decided to cut the fish landing quota for Solomon Gundy from its present level down to a level of zero for the next 3 years, because the catch of the Solomon Gundy fleet is exactly equal to 4% of all Canadian fish landing. Let me assure you of how fully cognizant I am of this transition to your island. But this government believes that we have to make the hard decision of reducing our present catch in order to rebuild fish stocks for a prosperous future. And by confining the cuts to a single community, we will be best able to soften the impact of any social or economic adjustments that this cut in quotas may bring about.
We voted the wrong way! This is what we get because we voted wrong! What does he mean?
Take away our quotas!
That can't be true! It doesn't make any sense!
Oh, it makes perfect sense.
I would like to
We've been overfishing for years.
What do you mean, we?
Prosperous.
Canada!
And a competitive Maritime Canada.
And the day of reckoning had to come.
The day of reckoning? For who? The day of reckoning is the day that anyone tries to stop me from fishing.
Yeah. Nobody is trying to stop you from fishing. The minister is not trying to stop you from fishing. Noel is not trying to stop you from fishing. And I certainly am not trying to stop you from fishing. The tragedy of this situation is that you people are being asked to sacrifice.
Now, everybody, stop it. Let's not get excited. Let's all try and remain calm. There are things that can be done, and I'm here, and I will stay here to help you, to give you information about the training program.
We've fished here for 250 years, right?
Right.
And we've been paying Alibaba and the 40 thieves in Ottawa for better than 100, right?
Right.
The highest taxes, and we're the poorest place. And what have we got to show for it? We got ourselves the right to pay more taxes. The GST and the PST and Jesus knows what new one next year. And now Ottawa's telling us we can't fish?
Well, just until the fish stocks are rebuilt.
We's fishermen on this island. That's what we do. That's what my husband did until it killed him. And now my son catches halibut and cod. We heard your message.
That's right.
Yeah. Now I say we give Ottawa a message they'll listen to for once.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
You works for him, right?
The government is my client, yes.
Your client?
Yes.
That's close enough, I figure. I say we hang him.
Hang him?
Yeah.
Hang him! Hang him! Hang him! Hang him!
Politicians, where you're going.
Stop it!
That's her.
What in God's name is going on here? Y'all lost your brains?
They stole our fishing rights, Mayor.
You think hanging this fellow's gonna bring him back? The only thing a hanging's gonna bring in is prison. Well, silly, you just got out of prison. Now, go on, get in your cars. Go home to your families. I said, go on, the lot of you.
You were the mayor.
Yeah, I am. And I'm very sorry for what happened here tonight. But obviously, you hit a nerve. You feeling all right?
Oh, fine, thank you.
Good. Now, maybe you can help me out, because I'll tell you, I'm a little confused. If we can't fish, how is it you propose that the people of this island are gonna earn a living?
Noel?
I think we'll deal with that later. I'm much more concerned about what happened tonight.
Well, miss, I'm very sorry for tonight. But what the hell did you expect them to do? Throw a party for you?
You think it's a joke?
No, I don't. But neither is taking away someone's livelihood. You tell these people they can't fish, you might as well stick a gun to their heads.
Well, they have just put a noose around Dexter's neck.
Well, maybe I shouldn't have stopped them.
Maybe I should call the Monties.
Noel. weren't we sent here to smooth over the removal of this island's fishing rights? And by attempting to lynch me, I mean, haven't they delivered themselves into our hands, these people? I mean, haven't they surrendered all possibility of future protest? Mission accomplished. What is this?
It's a pig.
It's a pig. It certainly is. Hi. Hi. the entire power structure of the world is based on a very simple principle.
And what is that?
You tell them. Big pigs eat first.
Dexter, don't you think we should call it a night?
Why? No. This whole evening has been so stimulating. Can't we stay here for a while?
Dexter, I think we should go.
Let's wrap with the Reverend. I mean, let's talk. He seems like an interesting guy. I mean, he's the mayor.
What is it exactly that you do, Dexter?
I'm a lawyer. I'm a liar. For the Prime Minister.
You work for the Prime Minister?
Yeah. That's right. Big liar.
Dexter. I think you're a very troubled man.
Don't look at the window. It's a teaser. The teaser has come. Oh, it's a terrible thing, you.
Electricity, and the sub won't work without electricity. It's na Ostro. Solomon Gund.
Oh, Alechna.
Alechna.
Together, way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
Well, Dexter came from Ottawa to stop us all from fishing.
Way haul away, we'll haul away, Joe.
But we'll go fishing anyway, and we won't ask permission.
Way haul away, we'll haul away,
Joe. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but I do have a question. Like, if we do have to negotiate or something, who are we supposed to talk to?
Well, the senior man, I guess, who doesn't seem to be a man at all.
Your cultural hostlessness.
Yep.
Wow.
Отлично.
And what was that?
She wants to defect.
Defect?
Yeah, not just her, all four of them do.
That's interesting. Do they know that the Russians are now our allies?
Maybe they've been underwater too long.
That might very well be.
Well, have you asked if there are any nuclear weapons on the submarine?
Вы держите нухлидю вас стержни.
Да, у вас здесь два нуклидих стержней. No problem на базе флота.
Yeah, they have two nuclear missiles. They're supposed to carry more, but there was some kind of problem at the naval base. That's interesting.
The hydrogen bomb.
And where do they keep them?
Oh, I think they're right behind you.
Are we bombarded with radiations right now?
No, I asked that earlier. Apparently not. Although they were close enough to a real accident for the rest of the crew to abandon the ship.
great.
Must have been up all night.
Yeah, most of it.
Where's your entourage? It's not like you to travel alone. You might have to make a speech or two.
So, where's the submarine?
Oh, it was in the harbor last night.
See a Russian submarine in the harbor last night?
I seem to have recalled seeing one. Yes.
На помощь, на помощь. Подводная лодка К-6-7-2. Позвать Мурманск. Код Р.
And thou shalt not play the hurt.
Sector S.
Let me just say, thou shalt set aside thy ordums, and thou shalt abide with me for a minute.
Shes, Sem, Dva, Pazvat, Murmans, Cold Air.
We have a winner here on Rap Radio.
Sto budjem jelats.
Sechas mi gripsi.
Hi.
Hi. Where is the submarine?
What submarine?
The Russian submarine that was in the harbor last night?
I didn't see no Russian submarine. Oh, but the teaser come last night. Maybe that's confusing you.
Did you see a Russian submarine there, Gus, old son?
Excuse me, what's the teaser?
Oftentimes when there's no moon in the sky and the weather's thick, the ghost ship teaser can be seen in the harbor. The sails all aflame, dead men hanging off the gunwales. And if you see her, you'll die before the year's done.
Good morning.
Good morning.
In case you don't know, this is Nelson Stidwell, Minister of Fisheries and Atmosphere.
The minister himself, huh?
In the flesh.
I know.
How you doing?
Good. You want some fish cakes?
No, thank you very much, but thank you for offering.
Right.
So, what's going on with the submarine? Did it leave or what?
No way. It's broken down and had only 4 sailors left on it. What are you trying to do?
Well, I'm not trying to do anything. You know, I was just thinking, seeing as Nelson has come all the way here from Ottawa, maybe he could help us out. You see, the people of this island are all worked up, because apparently there was some fellow on TV last night who was talking about our fishing rights being removed. Mm. Is that true?
You're the mayor, right? August Nickel.
Augustus Knickel, yes. But you can call me your worship.
Sounds fair.
So tell me something, Nelson. Is there any chance that we will get our fishing rights back?
Okay, first of all, this decision was not made by me, but by the entire cabinet, and only after considerable evaluation of quite an amount of expert analysis. So, it's not just something I can, you know, snap my fingers and undo, but I am here to listen, your worship.
Well, that's too bad, Nelson. That's all I am is a mayor. Like parking tickets, snow removal, dog licenses, that kind of thing. So what you're looking for is a nuclear submarine. Well, you're probably talking to the wrong fella.
Can you see the reference to Solomon Gundy?
Yeah, yeah.
And down here you can quite clearly make out the signatures of the representatives of England, France, and Holland.
Do you know, I first heard about this, my grandfather told me, I think I was 10. I didn't even think it was real.
Oh, it's real, all right.
I'm not questioning you, Zita. It's just that my grandfather was as crazy as Luke's dog.
Your grandfather was a fine man. He was a credit to the office of mayor and a credit to this town.
Zita, my grandfather died barking at the moon.
At least he didn't have the smell of liquor on his breath at this hour of the morning. And he was always a well-dressed man, as I recall.
You know, Zita, you're right. I should go get some new clothes. Thank you.
But just a minute now. Where are you going with that? Some people think the island's name derived from the nursery rhyme about Solomon Grundy, but the island is actually called Solomon Gundy because the Dutch fishermen who lived here used to make their version of Salmagundy, which is a sort of ragout of different kinds of meats. Being fishermen, of course, they used seafood for their Salmagundy, which consisted mostly of pickled herring and onions. Their recipe for pickled herring is still used here to this day and is called Solomon Gundy. Did you know that?
No, actually I didn't. This is a very interesting document.
It is, isn't it?
Hey, everybody, you want to find a chair there? Park yourselves in it. I'd like to thank you all for coming on short notice. And I think, first off, we should extend a warm welcome to a man at the back of the hall, the Honorable Nelson Stidwell, Minister of Fisheries and Atmosphere. Now, a lot of little generosity. He's a very brave man, is our minister coming to face us directly, particularly considering Mr. Lex Cannon here only narrowly escaped death by hanging last night. It's a fate I'm sure most of you think is more appropriately reserved for the minister himself. And what we are here to discuss today is a little-known thing called the Treaty of Utrecht. Now, do any of you know what the Treaty of Utrecht is? Sil?
No, sir, I don't.
Well, I'll explain it to you. The Treaty of Utrecht was a landmark in international diplomacy, and it was signed by England and France and a couple others in the year 17... What is it?
13.
Thank you, Zita. 1713. And as a result of the Treaty of Utrecht, a lot of land changed hands, including India, I think. But what is of extreme importance to everybody in this room is that there were some side letters to the Treaty of Utrecht that dealt with smaller matters. What I'm about to show you just looks like a wrinkly old, dusty old brown piece of paper. This is one of the original side letters to the Treaty of Utrecht, and it deals specifically with our island. Now, as you know, our ancestors were Dutch fishermen, and they used the island of Solomon Gundy as a fishing base as early as the 1630s. When the Treaty of Utrecht was signed, their interests were looked after. This letter, signed by England, France, and Holland, states that the fishermen of Solomon Gundy would have a special status. But if at any time they were unsatisfied with British rule, and they could leave the arrangement, and they could become self-governing. Well, I say we are not satisfied with British rule. Or to be a little more up to date, we are not satisfied with rule by Ottawa, whose power still legally derives from the British Crown. I say that the time has come for us to exercise our democratic right as provided in the Treaty of Utrecht, to separate from this country and to form the Republic of Solomon Gundy.
Excuse me, I would just like to clarify something for myself here. Is your worship suggesting that because you are unhappy with a certain conservation measure, that this little island separates itself from Canada and forms its own country?
That's exactly what I'm suggesting.
Well, I would like to remind your worship that Solomon Gundy has just barely 6,000 residents.
6,000 people who earn an honest living. And what would change? Nothing. We'll still sell our ground fish to Boston, same as we do now. We will sell our salt fish to Portugal, same as we do now. We will sell our herring to Germany, same as we do now. And we will sell our tuna to Japan, same as we do now. The only difference is that we will keep the money Ottawa takes from us. And we alone will determine what happens inside our waters.
Okay, folks, I realize there is a lot of frustration out here, and believe me, I'm not very happy about this either. But what a lot of people don't understand is Ottawa has the unenviable task of looking after the interests of the whole country, right? Central government's mandate or job, if you will, has always been to balance the interests of the parts against the interests of the whole.
I think that Ottawa balances the interests of those particular parts who elect people like you, Nelson, against the interests of the whole.
Thank you, Mr. Lex Cannon.
Look, Ottawa hasn't been bad to us. Ottawa's been good to us. Ottawa's money's what kept this economy afloat all these years.
Ottawa's what's keeping your economy afloat. I fish for a living.
Yeah, just because you think someday they'll give you a Senate seat, Dempster Millard, don't you go apologizing for a government that brings the rest of us nothing but hard times.
Well, if people had been sensible enough to vote for me when I ran for office, they'd have somebody in the government now, and we wouldn't have all these problems.
Your virtues aside, Mr. Millard, I think our problem is more one of center-periphery relations rather than who we elect specifically. We will never represent a significant mass of votes or organized capital. Therefore, we are politically marginalized, and we will always continue to be politically marginalized.
What do you mean by that?
What she means is we'd be better off running our own affairs.
I don't agree. Canada's going down the toilet because of all the problems, and we'd just be rats leaving the ship.
Okay, if, as the honorable resident has mentioned, this country is going down the toilet, it is going down the toilet because people like yourselves have let previous governments spend and borrow on your behalf. Now, you thought they were borrowing somebody else's money, but it was yours, and now we have to pay it back.
No, we don't. We'll be our own country.
Don't you realize you have your own country, and that country is Canada? Now, come on, how many people in this room consider themselves Canadians? Now, come on, don't be shy.
And how many people want to form the Republic of Solomon Gundy? Yeah! I hereby confirm this island has exercised its democratic right under the Treaty of Utrecht. Until we decide otherwise, we are now the Republic of Solomon Gundy.
What if the government doesn't agree? What do we do if they send in the army or something?
Well, I don't think you have to worry about that. See, the army only engages in situations that are somewhat serious. And this is not a discussion of reality. I am sorry, folks, but no one outside of this room is going to take you seriously.
Unless Solomon Gundy were a nuclear power. You see, we cannot lose our fishing rights. It's all we've got. So we bought the submarine.
Who'd you buy it from?
From the senior officer.
Excellent.
It's okay. It's a church room.
Thanks. I could use some right now.
It's good to see you're human.
Oh, I'm human, all right. Very much so.
These Russian sailors here speak English now, you. Go ahead, ask them anything you like. Don't be afraid, they can answer all your questions.
All right, do you speak English?
Of course.
Ask them something else.
Did you sell your submarine for a pickup truck?
Of course.
Do you have shipper brains?
Of course.
No, of course not. I am not canceling the trip. Right? And I don't want to spend the weekend in Brussels again. So make me a reservation at Hotel Crayon and make sure you get me a driver that can speak English this time.
Impressive man. Very impressive man.
Yes, that's right. Now, do you remember me mentioning to you that if anyone were to call for me, I'd be unavailable? Good. Then do it. Oh, yeah, Dexter. Do yourself a favor, will you? The next time you have this overwhelming urge to ejaculate some sort of professional jealousy that you have against me, why don't you do it in the privacy of your own bathroom instead of a goddamn public forum? Because if it happens again, Dexter, I'm gonna do my very best to make sure you wake up the morning after without a profession.
In a short statement transmitted by ship-to-shore radio, the islanders say that they are fed up with having their fishing rights sold down the river by both Halifax and Ottawa, and that they have decided to take their future into their own hands. The islanders claim that they have a legal right to secede from the 1713 Treaty of Utrecht, and they say they have the capability of enforcing their sovereignty. They are in possession of an abandoned Russian nuclear submarine, armed with cruise missiles carrying nuclear devices. Stay with us. We'll have more as soon as it becomes available.
We better call Dexter, no?
Mr. Lex Cannon is on the island of Solomon Gundy right now, Prime Minister, along with Nelson Stidwell.
Why?
Well, sir, that's the island that's losing their fishing rights, so we can make them available for the Belgian deal.
They don't know about the Belgian deal, do they?
No, no, sir. That's strictly confidential information.
The hell am I getting so excited about? Dexter is on the island, right? And if anybody can take care of a situation of this nature, it's Dexter. And then little Mr. Nelson can take the freaking flak, right? Why the hell should I take it? Let him take it.
That's right, sir.
I look like Adolf Hitler. Let me try that Elvis one again, okay?
Good night, Dix.
Good night, Noel. Sweet dreams.
You too.
Mon petit bébé d'amour.
Did you have to come here?
No. But I seem to remember getting a phone call last night.
The idea was that I'd spend some time on my own. Give my head a chance to clear. That is why I took this job, remember?
Please. Let's not have to deal with that now, okay?
Found it.
Hey, come take a look.
Okay. I think it may be time for me to go back to Ottawa.
Back to the hotel?
No.
His name's Hamlet. One of my flock willed him to me.
Oh, nice.
How nice. He's a pig.
I'm sure I'm not the first to point that out, but you don't seem like a minister.
Now, how's a minister supposed to seem?
Well, not like you. Do you believe in God?
I am a minister.
You didn't answer my question.
Well, that's right, I didn't.
Do you believe in God?
Not really.
Do you ever mention that in your sermons?
Are you crazy?
So you're a minister?
Yeah.
And a mayor?
Yep.
And a mini-pot golf entrepreneur.
Well, it's hard to earn a living these days.
They won't let you keep the submarine, you know. It won't happen.
I'm gonna show you something. The man was a fisherman, turn of the century. He worked off the Grand Banks on a schooner with his son. They were dory mates. And a dory's like a little rowboat. Anyway, this one winter, a terrible storm came up, and they completely lost all contact with the schooner. So they decided that they'd row for land. The weather just kept getting worse and worse, and it got colder and colder, and it got so cold that his son wanted to go to sleep. And the father tried to keep the son going, but it didn't work, and the boy froze solid in front of him like a block of ice. And the only promise his wife ever asked of him is that no matter what happened on the water, that he would bring their son home. You see, by this time, he had no feeling left in his fingers. And so he took off his mittens, and he dipped his hands into the ocean, and he held his hands on the oars until they froze to the wood. And then he started to row. He rowed for 150 miles until he finally reached the harbor. And he picked his son up, and he carried him up the main street, up past all of the shops and the church. He carried him all the way up to the gates of the graveyard. And then
What? Where did you get those?
From the submarine. You can buy one from Luba for about 20 bucks, which is a great price for an AK-47.
It worked well at Cambrai, and it still works well today, you.
My uncle's still got his World War II Mauser machine gun. Ammo and all.
And Gordon Hibbs got that bazooka the drug smugglers left behind?
Have you lost your mind?
No, we lost our fishing rights.
You can't do this. These people trust you. They listen to you. You have a responsibility to them.
Sometimes,
you cannot do this.
Sometimes, when nobody is giving you what you need, you have to take it.
Not this way.
Well, you can say that because you have a job.
Augustus, old son.
Mm-hmm. What is the story with this fellow with the fire extinguisher? What is he?
Well, it's very interesting, Dexter. It turns out that he's a walking fire hazard.
He's a fire hazard? Why?
From what I can gather, spontaneous combustion is a big problem in the area of the Caucasus he comes from.
Spontaneous combustion?
Now, he claims that he can feel it coming on, but, well, I think you'd have to bear in mind he just spent 6 months in a confined space.
Tell me something, my wingnut friend. I understand you're the submarine's missile programming officer. So now you're going to be programming missiles for the Republic of Solomon Gundy.
Of course.
He speaks English?
Of course.
He speaks English?
I wouldn't count on it.
No, he does. He does. He does. Listen, tell me something. Have you chosen your targets?
Well, you know, this morning he was mumbling something about Mount Rushmore.
Oh, that's brilliant. Oh, an American target. Yeah. American target. That'll capture Ottawa's attention much more than the Canadian one. Well, but there are two, right? There are two missiles. What about the other one?
I was thinking it should be a Canadian site, you know, for balance.
Do me a favor. Make it Canada's wonderland.
Of course. Very funny, Dexter. Wake up. It's not a joke. These are real guns and real missiles, and you know that Ottawa is probably getting real serious about it right now.
Thank you.
Is this Treaty of Utrecht thing for real or what?
Well, I've seen the letter, and it seems to be genuine.
Well, listen. What we have to ascertain, Dexter, and I know if anybody can do it, you can do it, is whether there is any possibility, I mean any possibility, the smallest possibility of a genuine threat from these missile things.
Well, I cannot say with absolute confidence that they are not capable of doing anything with the missiles. They seem to have the cooperation of the submarine's missile programming officer.
Well, all we can ask from you, Dexter, is your best.
I will do my best, Prime Minister.
If that's the Premier of Nova Scotia again, tell him I'm taking a dump. A long and pleasant one.
Hello? Yes, of course. It's the White House.
Hello, Mr. President. Well, I appreciate you calling under the sir. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Vice President. No, I can't say that we've exactly pinpointed the precise location of the submarine. I can't say that. I certainly do remember the lessons I've learned recently. Yes, you can count on me. I'm not going to lose control of the situation. Yes. Oh, definitely. If we need anything, we'll be right on the phone to you. Yes, sir. Well. Thank you. Thank you very much, Mr. President. Mr. Vice President. Thank you.
Well, we've been getting no shortage of calls from Moscow. Naturally enough, they want their submarine back. We could bring this to an end, sir. All we have to do is make the decision to cancel the Belgian deal and give the islanders back their fishing quota.
You know, over the years, there's one thing that I've held in my heart in terms of political life in Canada. And it's an adage that you could do well to remember yourself. You've got to dance with them that brung you. But, of course, that's a minor consideration when a statesman makes his decision.
I have something here that I think you should take a look at.
What is this?
Well, as you're aware, I've just returned from Solomon Gundy, where I just managed to take a few photographs of a Russian nuclear submarine.
You did.
Those photographs are taken at a small harbor called Herring Cove on the eastern side of the island of Solomon Gundy.
And a lovely place it is.
It sure is.
You know, Nelson, you may just have a future after all.
Programming missiles for the Republic of Solomon Gundy. Mount Rushmore. No problem.
Hey! Gavno!
Doing?
Practicing.
Do you want to be left alone?
No, no, not at all. Does it matter in the end what we do in this life?
Are you dying, Dexter?
Does it matter what we do? I'm asking.
Yes, I believe it does. Are you frightened?
No. Are you?
Oh, yes.
We have a statement.
Mr. Sidwell, this is submarine
room
campaign.
How are you? Good to see you. Is there any chance of a radiation leak?
Does the government plan to negotiate or give Solomon Dundee back the fishing rights?
Are the missiles armed and ready, sir?
Mr. Sidwell.
Is there any chance of military action?
A statement, sir, please.
Dexter.
Hello, Nelson.
You know Bill Paxton, don't you?
Oh, very well.
Look, the Russians, as you might expect, want their submarine back. And nobody's taking this Republic thing too seriously.
Except those reporters.
It has no foundation in reality.
It has foundation in law. So, Nelson, how about those fishing rights?
It's a completely unrelated subject.
Look, we were sent here to talk about one thing. And that's getting the Russian submarine back into the hands of the Russians. Oh, and guess what? The sub's crew showed up at an oil rig off Sable Island, and they want their vessel back.
The submarine is in our waters, and we decide what to do with it.
Who is this bozo?
This bozo is Christ's representative on Earth, the mayor of town, and the acting head of state of the Republic of Solomon Gundy.
Little tit.
I think that the point that the islanders would like to make is that all they want is to fish. So if you give them back their fishing quotas, all this is going to come to an end.
Whatever happened to the idea of economic flexibility? We've all got to make adjustments from time to time, right? The world does not stand still.
Economic readjustment for you is another job in another governmental department. For us, it is the end of everything. A whole way of life.
Yeah, that may be so. But right now, the Russians want their sub back. Those are the rules of this game. Do you understand?
Whose rules?
Why don't you ask your foreign minister? Or is that you too?
Reduce foreign fishing quotas.
It's not on the table.
I don't understand this. What is it we have to do? Do we have to aim a missile or two in your direction?
Oh, so what? Now I'm hearing some sort of a nuclear threat?
What you're hearing is a cry of desperation, Mr. Paxton. And desperate people do desperate things.
Dexter! Dexter! Stop it! You've gone native, Dexter! Listen to me now. What these people don't understand is if they keep going the way they're going, the hammer's gonna drop, and it ain't gonna be a pretty sight.
She studies the black book. She picked up the broom. She studies the black book. Call the witch master.
Do you think she's a witch?
Yeah.
This is getting crazy. People don't realize what they're doing. You're talking about a nuclear submarine here, not a highway bridge or a golf course. And I don't see you do anything to stop them.
That's true. I'm not doing anything to stop them.
What's going on, Dexter?
What? What do you mean?
There's something I don't know. Something you were saying but not saying on the boat with Nelson. What is it?
Oh, you mean the Belgian deal?
The Belgian deal?
Yeah.
What are we selling this time?
Coal scrubbers.
Coal scrubbers?
A politically connected Canadian company is selling high-priced coal emission scrubbers to a Belgian utility in exchange.
We give them increased fishing quotas.
Exactly.
Solomon Gandhi's fishing quotas.
How can you stay with that idiot?
Because he needs me.
Why aren't you together?
You know he can't do that. Politically.
Well, maybe you can't leave him. Professionally.
There's a fire on the submarine.
Lord, Diane, Rosie, I, Jesus.
There's six of them and they're coming in real low, right? Jump fast!
I can't make them out.
I can help you with that.
Dexter?
Is everybody all right?
I'm all right.
We're all right.
I'm sorry about starting things off with the flare gun, Gus, old son.
No, you didn't start things off, Bunsy. Things were wanting to start off on their own.
Augustus!
Oh, you'll
be
all right. I just have to get
up.
Augustus! No! It's all right, Dexter. All right. Sil, go call Dr. Roper.
I'm okay.
Oh, Jesus.
Bunsy, would you bring me some of those shirts?
I'm okay, Sarah. I'm okay. Okay. Hold on. I'm going away.
Hold on.
Going away.
Hold on.
Going away. Please. It's very cold.
Blanket.
Oh, cold.
A blanket. We need a blanket.
Thurgood, bring us a blanket.
It's all right. Hold on.
I'm still here.
Sarah.
I'm still here.
Yes.
Oh, I'm going.
Hold on. It's all right.
I'm going.
Yes.
I don't know how to live in this world.
Still cold. I'm sorry.
think I should go to Ottawa.
What?
Tell him to come pick up the submarine.
Do you think that's the right thing to do?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't want to see anybody else get killed.
You never thought this might happen?
Thinking it and seeing it, they're two different things.
So the government wins.
Yeah, I guess they do.
And Dexter dies for nothing.
What are you saying?
If you really care about this island, you cannot stop now. You have to see this through to the end.
Big pigs eat first.
Well, Nelson, this is Augustus Kinnickel. Dexter was killed by one of your helicopters. Nelson, just shut up for a second. The missiles are armed, targeted, and they're ready to go at a moment's notice. You have 10 hours to deliver written confirmation of the return of all fishing rights and amnesty from prosecution. When we have that in our hands, we'll return the submarine. And if we see anything coming at us, I mean anything, either over the water or under the water or on radar or sonar, we'll launch them. That's all. Oh, God.
I thought you didn't believe.
I'm beginning to sniff the temptation.
It was something queer, you. At about midnight, a little smoochy cat came in and sat all hunched up by the fire. It came in through the keyhole. Then through the keyhole, 25 cats come, and the last was the biggest. And the big cat says to the little ones, "Pak on! That's Dutch for lay hold and kill him." And they all turned on him. Then Jack, he cut the paw off the big one with his knife. When he did that, they all went back through the keyhole. He examined the paw, and he found that it was a hand with a ring onto it. He knew he wouldn't be killed anymore that night. In the morning, the farmer's wife was sick, so they sent for the doctor. He come, and he reached for her hand, but she wouldn't pull it out. He hauled it out, and it was cut off. So Jack, the sailor, went to his room and brought the paw. And he said, "Whosoever belongs to this hand was trying to kill me last night." And then the farmer says to his wife, "So, you're the one who has been killing my men." So they took her out and built a fire and burned her. She was a witch, nothing but a witch.
Where are you from?
Rivière du Loup.
Are you kidding?
No. Why?
Well, I don't know. I thought you were some kind of Paris Francie pants.
That's only recently. I thought you were some sort of a hick.
Oh, I am. But only recent.
Just a whip of a hydrogen ball.
You flatter me. West, 44 degrees north, just about Rapid City, North Dakota.
Mount Rushmore.
The second one, 4375 north, 7955 west. Canada's Wonderland.
Excuse me, gentlemen.
Oh, you're brilliant, Knickel. I really gotta hand it to you. Guy calls his own bluff. What a genius.
Извини, дело тушилка. Они приматься все хотели из вод на корабль.
What's he saying?
He's saying if they make a mistake, the missiles will either launch immediately or detonate on board the sub.
Do you have any idea about the mess you've created here?
We didn't create this.
We? Well, so we're a team now, are we?
Nelson, what are we going to say to the Americans?
About what?
about the fact that there's a 200-kiloton warhead aimed at Mount Rushmore.
We tell them nothing.
Nothing?
We contain that information until we're certain the missiles can't be shut down.
Like you contain the information about the Belgian deal?
Cabinet information is circulated on a strictly need-to-know basis.
Dexter was right, Nelson. It is people like you who create situations like this.
People like us? Have you lost a completely missed Denoye?
Look, Paxton.
Well, like Knickel here making an international crisis over a couple of halibut.
Man, just shut up, Paxton.
Aiming a nuclear missile at Canada's Wonderland. You know, Arnie Crowley's daughter works at Canada's Wonderland. You do know who he is, don't you, Knickel? Only the Minister of Finance. We gotta get her out of there.
Use your phone. That's what it's for.
Right. Wait a minute. What'd you just say to me?
I think he told you to shut up.
You told me to shut up?
I told you to shut up.
I don't believe this. Here we are in the middle of an international disaster and some fish-scaling mist.
Wij willen ogenblikkelijk de premier zien.
Messieurs, veuillez vous asseoir, s'il vous plaît.
Надо батарейка компьютер.
Скерджей, это опять.
Мне надо батарейка компьютер.
He needs like a little mini computer, like a battery powered mini computer.
We need a mini computer, battery powered, now.
Hey, wait, a computer? You've got a computer. Will this do? Да?
Ну да.
Вот именно это и нужно. Да, да. Срочно подай гражданский городок.
Почему нет контакта? Не могу понять ничего. Попробуйте еще раз.
Синовилос!
Yes!
Well done, sir. Very well done.
We did it, Nelson.
We did it.
We winged it.
Oh, thank God.
If he exists.
It's done. Turned off. Goddamn thing is shut down. Huh? What? Yeah. You're kidding. No way. Nelson, you're not gonna believe this.
Try me.
The Belgian utility company's Flemish. But the fishing rights are supposed to go to the French Belgians, so the company's pulling out of the deal. They're more screwed up than we are.
Wait a second. If they don't buy our coal scrubbers, that means we don't give them any extra fish.
Bingo.
What are you talking about?
What we're talking about is the fact that you are going to get your fishing rights back.
And Dexter dies for nothing.
Yes.
Well, unless you count money.
Wait a minute, you mean this whole thing has just been some kind of game?
It would seem so, yes.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's unbelievable. It's unbelievable.
Oh, God.
Nelson, my man. I want to make a toast.
To men with balls.
Thank you.
fucker's got like Russian letters on it.
I think it's a bomb. Like it's an H bomb or an A bomb or some kind of bomb. It's a bomb. Definitely.
Maybe it was like a war, man, and no one told us about it.
Yeah. You think it's gonna blow?
No, it's a dud.
What are we gonna do with it?
I think we should sell it for a shitload of speed.
Yeah. Yeah!